Glory be to the Triune God. Martin Luther King Jr. was an African-American activist who played a predominant role in the fight for the rights of the blacks in America. At the Great March in Washington, he delivered his famous speech, I Have a Dream Today, where he talks of a dream that one day the glory of the Lord shall be revealed and all flesh shall see it together. A poignant line from his speech, and I quote, with this faith we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope. In today's times, in our lives, despair has attained mountainous proportions. We need to carve out this despair a stone of hope, and it is faith, and faith alone, that can help us to do so. We need a faith that can move mountains, the very same faith that Mother Mary had when she was told by Angel Gabriel about being a handmaiden of the Lord. She accepted what was told because she had immense faith in the Almighty. Mother Mary said, may it be to me as you have said. Throughout her life, Mother Mary was submissive to God. She feared being a social outcast and had no idea how she would raise the child without Joseph. Emotions churned in her mind as thoughts stumbled inside her, but she never lost faith. God did test her, but there wasn't a moment when her faith faded. At the wedding at Cana, she asked her servants to follow Jesus' instructions when they ran out of wine. Just as Mother Mary turned to Jesus for a solution to the problem, we need to look towards God's answers to our problems and not look for a human solution. Mary's presence at the foot of the cross shows that she could tolerate the pain of seeing her beloved son being put to death, and the strength came from her faith. Put to test, Mary continued to believe that Jesus was the Son of God and that by his sacrifice he would transform the destiny of mankind. The resurrection was a definitive confirmation of Mary's faith. The recent pandemic is God's way to induce faith and not fear, and it's faith that keeps us moving in these tough times. It's quite disheartening to see the present world moving away from God. We are so doomed in happiness gained out of material things and have no time to live a faith-filled spiritual life. We are never worthy of God's standards. The scripture says, having faith as big as a mustard seed can move mountains. No matter in what situation we are stranded, Mother Mary's life shows us how to hang in on the Lord's strength through faith. I would like to conclude by quoting Matthew 21:22. And whatever you ask in prayer, you will receive if you have faith. Let us all cultivate a faith-filled spiritual life, a life worth living for our true loving God as His children. May God bless you all. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.